हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन यू आर वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स। एंड टुडे वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड। इफ यू रिमेंबर, फॉर द लास्ट टाइम इन द लास्ट थियरी क्लास वी वर स्टडिंग केमिकल कोऑर्डिनेशन, वेयर वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी, एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स, हॉर्मोन्स, द केमिकल मैसेंजर्स, their mechanism of action, different type of hormones which include steroid and non-steroid hormones, and mechanism of action of steroid and non-steroid hormone. That was topic of our discussion as far as last lecture was concerned. Students, today we will be dealing with a very important gland of a body, endocrine gland of a body, which regulates all mechanisms and which helps to maintain the body regulation or homeostasis, and major role played by the gland, and that gland is called as pituitary gland. So when we will be studying this pituitary gland, we will be defining the pituitary gland. We will study anatomy, internal structure of the pituitary gland, the hormones which are secreted by this pituitary gland, and pituitary gland, how it is regulated by hypothalamus. Then we will be discussing the function of hormones which are secreted by this pituitary gland, both the lobes of pituitary gland, anterior and the posterior pituitary gland, as these both lobes have different functions as their secretion is different. Now, pituitary gland, the master gland of the body. Why it is called to be a master gland of this body? It is small one. As far as structure of this pituitary gland is concerned, it is a small gland, it is P-shaped gland. This gland present in the head, and it functions as main endocrine gland of the body. As far as a normal pituitary gland is concerned, its color is quite reddish gray, and it is bean shaped, it is P-shaped gland. It is called master gland because it produces the hormone that controls other gland and many other function, including the growth of body. Means pituitary gland is responsible for the regulation of activities of other gland also. That's why pituitary gland is called as master gland of the body, and the regulation of growth is all over maintained by the gland, and that gland is nothing but pituitary gland is. Now let us see internal structure or anatomy of this pituitary gland. As I said, this gland is also called as P gland because its shape is P-like, and near about it weighs about 500 mg, and it is present in the brain. It is located at the base of brain, and 1 centimeter is the diameter of this pituitary gland. Now, as far as location of this pituitary gland is concerned, it lies in hypophyseal fossa, that is cella thoracica region of this sphenoid bone. It is present in the cella thoracica region in the sphenoid bone below this hypothalamus, because it is linked with hypothalamus. Pituitary gland itself is regulated by hypothalamus, so it is present in the sphenoid bone region, in the cella thoracica zone, in the cella thoracica region. We call it as a hypophyseal fossa. A fold of duramater that covers the pituitary gland and has an opening for the passage of infundibulum, that is a stalk. You will see that a dura mater which covers pituitary gland and there is presence of infundibulum or stalk which helps to connect this pituitary gland to the hypothalamus. See, this is nothing but a pituitary gland where you can see this greenish portion. See, this is nothing but a pituitary gland. Pituitary gland in the hypophyseal fossa of a spinoid bone. See, in the spinoid bone, in the hypophyseal fossa, there is presence of this pituitary gland. See, a structure of a pituitary gland, how it looks. Now, you can see here, it is third ventricle zone and this is pituitary gland. Pituitary gland which is divided into two lobes. One is anterior one and second one is the posterior one. And there is presence of a stalk-like region which we call it as infundibulum. See here, this is anterior lobe of pituitary gland and this is posterior lobe of pituitary gland. Here you can mark this pituitary stalk, hypothalamo-hypophyseal tract. You can see this is nothing but a zone which is called as, or this tract is called as hypothalamo-hypophyseal tract. Region is hypothalamo-hypophyseal. That means hypothalamic stalk, hypothalamic connection is with a posterior zone of pituitary gland. See here, this is posterior region, this is anterior region. Hypothalamo-hypophyseal tract you can observe here, and this is nothing but a posterior lobe of pituitary gland and this is nothing but anterior part of pituitary gland. And here you can see the pituitary portal system. This pituitary gland is attached with this hypothalamic region, hypothalamus, that is in direct contact with the posterior pituitary gland, and this is nothing but a structure of pituitary gland. Pituitary gland, it is consist of anterior and a posterior lobe, posterior region, and you can mark the region in between anterior and posterior lobe which we call it as intermediate lobe also. Let us see the division of pituitary gland. It is, I have already shown you in the diagram, which consists of main two parts. Now, though it is divided into two main parts, but it is originated from two different types of cells. The first part of this pituitary gland is called as an anterior pituitary gland, also called as adenohypophysis. Pituitary itself is called as hypophysis. Anterior region of this pituitary gland is called as anterior hypophysis or adenohypophysis. And another lobe, it is with neural connection, so it becomes a neurohypophysis, and this region is called as posterior pituitary gland. See here, anterior pituitary gland and posterior pituitary gland. Anterior pituitary gland is called as adenohypophysis, whereas posterior pituitary gland, it is called as neurohypophysis. Anterior pituitary, it is an upgrowth of glandular epithelium from the pharynx region and mainly responsible for the secretion of peptide hormones, that is protein hormones, basically we will say. Posterior gland, posterior pituitary gland or neurohypophysis It is formed from the nervous tissues. So, as it is formed from the nervous tissues, we are calling it as neurohypophysis, and these are made from the nerve cells. Okay. And these nerve cells, if we see the support, if we see the connection, then it is surrounded by, it is supported by glial cells, means a glue-like cells, and these cells are also called as pituicytes. Now, what is function of these pituicytes? What is function of these specific cells? It plays very important role in storage of hormones. Whatever secreted by hypothalamus, these are stored in this region. Now, relation of hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Let us see what is connection between these two glands, that is hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Now, this connection is, it is between the hypothalamus and the pituitary gland. It is results from hormones released from the hypothalamic neuron. That means whatever hormones secreted by pituitary gland that are secreted due to signal of hypothalamus, direct contact of hypothalamus exists between pituitary and hypothalamus. So whatever hormone secreted by pituitary gland, that is due to the signal from hypothalamus. This hypothalamus has two different connections with the pituitary gland. Now, one connection is with anterior pituitary and second connection is with a posterior pituitary. The connection to this anterior pituitary or adenohypophysis is by means of a portal system, a blood system. Whereas in case of posterior lobe, posterior pituitary, neurohypophysis, it is directly through the neurons. That means neuronal connection exists, lies between pituitary gland and the hypothalamus. So this is basic difference between these two. Portal connection exists between anterior pituitary and hypothalamus, and neural connection directly exists between this adenohypophysis and the hypothalamus. Now let us talk about blood supply to the pituitary gland. How blood is supplied? Arterial blood supply. Now, the superior and inferior hypophyseal arteries, branches of internal carotid, they are responsible for a supply of blood to the pituitary gland. This anterior pituitary lobe is supplied indirectly by blood from hypothalamus. See here, the connection between hypothalamus and again pituitary. The blood, it is supplied by, because it is the connection between anterior pituitary and hypothalamus, it is by portal blood system. So this blood is directly, indirectly provided by hypothalamus. Now, and posterior region, posterior zone, it is supplied directly. So this is difference between these two regions, how blood is supplied, because one is directly with this neural connection, that is neurohypophysis, and another one is portal blood system. So this is basic difference between these two. Now let us see the venous drainage. Now, hormones from the both pituitary gland, anterior and the posterior, venous blood leaves the gland and enter the venous sinuses between the layers of dura mater. See, venous blood, that is from this pituitary lobes, that leaves the gland and directly enters in the venous sinuses between the layers of dura mater. Again, you can see the structure of pituitary gland, where you can see the connection towards anterior pituitary and connection towards posterior pituitary, how portal blood system connection of hypothalamus and anterior pituitary exists, and neural connection between hypothalamus and posterior pituitary or adenohypophysis or neurohypophysis, that exists. So दिस इज अबाउट द सिस्टम. अगेन वी विल सी हॉर्मोन्स ऑफ पिट्यूटरी ग्लैंड इन नेक्स्ट पार्ट. बी कंटिन्यू.